Do you have your binder? You do. May I have it, please? Goodness, you were quite thorough, it seems, in the survey. Yes. Perfect. I see you right here. Do you have any problems filling out this survey? Okay. Just to explain, our process is very thorough. So I will review your survey answers, and we do this so that if you have any other thoughts you may have forgotten, if you change your mind on any answers, if you have had second thoughts regarding any previous answers, those answers may be adjusted now. But once in our computer system, things work very quickly from that point forward. And so it is much easier to adjust things prior to matches being made. Yes. Okay. So, we will begin. I have the planetary ID. Do you have a personal identification that you prefer to be addressed by? That is very lovely. Age, and is that planetary or interstellar age? Planetary. Okay. Species. What species do you relate with? Is that also your genetic species identification, or simply a relational identification? Identification is that tech. With the technology aspect in mind, are cyborgs an acceptable match? I completely understand. So, I see here you do have some preferences regarding physical characteristics. Feathers and fur seem to be acceptable. Have you given any thought to tentacles or scales? Partners with tentacles can be quite exciting at times, I've heard. So, a possibility. And what about scales? Have you given any further consideration to the scaled species? I must say, matches do come easier, I believe is the word, when physical characteristics are not biased against. Yes, those who are more open-minded, I guess, would be the way you would phrase that, correct? Open-minded? Yes. The more open-minded tend to have much better and long-lasting matches. Just something to keep in mind. We will move on to relocation. I see you have quite a large area that you have considered for relocation. You are very broad-minded in this area, most assuredly. So, let's look at this a different way, a different angle, if you will. Is there any area that you would not like to relocate to? Any specific planets or even quadrants that you are not comfortable relocating to? Thank you. Yes, please. And is that the entire Alpha Prime quadrant, or specifically one of the planets in Alpha Prime? You seem very broad-minded in that area. Let us move on to speaking about your ideal first encounter. Are you looking for something more mentally challenging? Something more on the emotionally soft side? I believe your word is romantic. Are you looking for something like that for the first encounter? With this in mind, do you have any food preferences or dietary restrictions or requirements? Ah, yes. Yes, I do see the note here. Now, have you added any other restrictions to your dietary needs? No, I do think ruling out mind-altering chemicals is good for the first encounter. It is always better to be aware and know exactly what you're getting into with these matches. For you and for a partner. You as a mortal human are warm-blooded, correct? And are you looking for another warm-blooded match, or are you open to hot or cold-blooded matches as well? a land or water preference? So, not really looking to live full time on Aquarius 7. So a match with someone from a water world with no land is not really an option. No, that makes perfect sense. You have feet that are not webbed. Probably be quite the adjustment for you. And did you note any light sensitivities? A few other simple questions. Do you have any pets? No. Okay. Are you open to a match that has pets? Only lower intelligence pets. Oh, I see you've had a bad encounter. Yes, well, that can definitely skew how you look at pets of a higher intelligence level. I can understand that. Those little fire-breathing monsters are not quite my idea of a good time either. Now, let's see. Places you have traveled. You've been to a side planet. That is very, very interesting for a mortal human. Oh, and I see you've met a tick-tick alien. I do find the tick-tick species quite interesting. And have you actually traveled to Tectara? How did you find it? It is a lovely place. Okay. Ah. And you've been to Garcias. Have you met many Hibians? They're very fun, aren't they? traveled. You are a very well-traveled mortal, I must tell you. So, this list is quite extensive. I will continue entering it after our meeting is adjourned. Have you thought of any questions you would like to ask at this point? Mm-hmm. The reason behind the list of places you have traveled, we would like an extensive list so that we can see who all you might have previously encountered. Planetary lists is a wonderful way to see whom you have encountered, how open the mind and spirit might be. It helps us create a more thorough and satisfactory match. We are almost done. Did you list any odd talents or abilities? There are some that will find a double-jointed human quite fascinating. The last note is regarding teleporters and molecular transference. Have you used either mode of transportation? Are you comfortable with both the teleportation or molecular transference? Do you have a preference? I also prefer molecular transference. I do understand. All right. Would you like to be included in some beta testing? Yes, I will pass you on to our beta tester, and she will handle showing you various profiles of possible matches. I have come across several that I think you would be very good with, but if you are interested in the beta testing, it is much easier to show you options with our new beta services. Perfect. Okay. I will
binder and finish entering the planetary information from places you have traveled. And I'm going to send you out this door and to the left. Take the first hallway on the right. Yes, it just opens into one large room, and that's where you will find our beta testing services. Just tell them that I sent you, okay? I do hope that you find your perfect